There's no turning back. From now on, I will have to do without a carriage. The Bastille is to the south of the Temple. What are you blaming yourself for, monsieur?
No! Get back! Assassin!
I'm not your enemy. My only aim is to defeat the Royal Army.
Why should I believe you? It's true that you can speak. Maybe you're truly not one of them.
Dites-moi, what is this chaos? What disaster has befallen the Place Royale?
That's where we, loyal patriots, had gathered. A band of brave souls armed with what paltry weapons we could find. A few old sabers, some rusty muskets. That's all we needed to stop the enemy's advance. Alas, the tyrant riposted from the heights of the Bastille. His cannons tore us to shreds. I could only flee while my comrades fell as heroes for our nation. What's the point of surviving if you must bend the knee to a bloodthirsty despot?
Monsieur.
Leave me now. I'll soon join my comrades. Leave me, I say. I already have one foot in the grave.
The Bastille's cannons destroyed the square. What a ghastly massacre. It seems that the artillerymen used Monsieur Leclos' devastating cannonballs. will have to go through the moat to get into the Bastille.
That's enough, Monsieur le Comte. My assistants and I are exhausted. We're not gravediggers, à la fin.
Oh, I understand. The task you have been given does not please you. Perhaps you do not find it worthy of your high qualifications.
Indeed. My family has been dedicated to serving the kingdom for over a century, and you cannot ignore what it has cost us. I refuse to fall that low.
Very well. As you wish. Since this is the case, you will have a more prestigious assignment starting today. Was there anything else?
What about my assistants? Will they come with me?
Unfortunately not, mon ami. But I promise you that they will never complain about their fate again.
Alain! Par pitié, au nom du ciel!
I'm listening, monsieur.
They abandoned me. The jailers. It's been days, maybe weeks, since I've seen another living soul. I'm hungry, madame. I'm ravenous.
Here, monsieur.
Bless you, madame. I wish you the best of luck. The fickle Lady Luck will have her work cut out for her when you're face to face with the executioner.
The executioner?
Oh, yes. You won't escape him. Ding! Ding! His icy blade won't spare you. Mark my words. He's made so many heads roll. Asa, they all fall like withered apples. The executioner is brave as long as it stays cold. If he were to meet the flame, his ashes would be less bold.
Monsieur le Comte! Monsieur le Comte, are you there? The prisoners, they're suffering! What is the meaning of this?
As promised, I have interceded on your behalf. The King has named you Gouverneur de la Bastille. Do you realize what an honor this is?
Put an end to this sinister farce, Monsieur le Comte. Order your machines to unhand me at once. Ah!
Listen to my voice, mon ami. Nothing but my voice.
The death sentences delivered by court order are nothing more than cowardly murders. Barbaric crimes committed legally in the name of the entire nation. These cruel laws are the doing of the tyrants who rule us. They are the chains they have always used to oppress the human race. And that, mes amis, is why the death penalty must be abolished.
Well said. Most faithful servant.
Monsieur, listen to me.
But I can no longer do what you ask of me.
Listen to me, Bossan.
Kill, kill, and kill again.
What do you mean? Of what crimes do you accuse yourself?
The heads must roll. They must roll straight into the pit.
Cela suffit. Who are you, monsieur?
Who am I? Oh. I am Charles-Henri Sanson, executor of court rulings.
The executioner of Paris?
The executioner?
Oh no. Not anymore. That death factory. We had to lead the horde of the tortured victims there, and hand them over to killers who are far more efficient and skilled than us. When I tried to give up my position, the King and the Count offered me a new role. Greffier at the Bastille. An easy job. And I fell into their trap. But now that I think about it, they must be the ones who sent you. They want my head.
You're rambling. I am Aegis, their worst enemy. Come to rescue Monsieur de Vaucanson.
Oh. His Majesty's honored guest. The man for whom our good king reserves his most ruthless treatment. No one deserves to be punished like that. Here, take this key. Monsieur de Vaucanson's cell is downstairs. And do not delay. He is dying, madame. He's dying.
Tonight, mon enfant. Oh, mon Dieu. They did it. They did it. They've turned my sweet daughter into a cold machine.
It's all right. Stay calm.
Well, Ludia, what has Cagliostro told you? Has he sent you to put me out of my misery?
No. I'm going to get you out of here. Let me help you.
There's no point. I'm burning with fever, and I'm already short of breath. Death lurks around every corner in this prison. I couldn't escape it. I'm not long for this world.
No, you can't. Outside, your automats are slaughtering men, women, and children. What you have done, monsieur, only you can undo.
What I have done, the miracles I performed, the wonders I gave to this kingdom, it was nothing but vanity. I closed my eyes to it for so long. Mesmer, Cagliostro, souls snatched from their eternal rest like water from a well. I should have set fire to the workshop. I should have melted my creations.
It's not too late to stop the massacre.
I don't have the strength. You must...
Speak, monsieur. Say something awful.
You must stop them. The king and his loathsome henchman, Cagliostro, the master of the machines. He gives them their orders. He must be silenced at all costs. Take my hand.
Monsieur. Monsieur. Father.
No, no, my pauvre enfant. I am not your father. No more than you are, Athenais. You're but the vessel that contains what is left of her broken soul. I don't want to die without hope. In the name of what is left of her in you, in the name of her love for you, I beg you to free her from the purgatory our enemies have confined her to.
I will grant your wish, monsieur.
Do you realize what that means? Are you ready to make that sacrifice?
The ultimate sacrifice.
Ma fille. I shall never see her darling face again. Ma petite. You must set her free. Bring her back into the light. The light.
Monsieur. Monsieur.
My daughter, will you never listen? This machine belongs to the king now, Vulisavi. There's nothing I can do about it.
Did he also order you to torture her?
The king wants me to make some improvements.
And you obey him just like that?
That's enough, Athenais. Let me work. And from now on, I forbid you from coming in here without my permission.
You're no better than your master, Papa!
Use this boat to reach the Seine. As soon as I am on dry land, I shall return to the Cordeliers convent. I am sure they are waiting for me with bated breath. Citoyen, I come bearing sad tidings. Monsieur de Vaucanson has passed away. I was present for his last breath in his cell at the Bastille.
Juste ciel. Requiescat in pace.
Mon Dieu, it is a cruel fate that has taken my dearest friend from me today.
Eugène. Ce pauvre Eugène. I cannot suffer such a horrible injustice.
Was he at least able to tell you something before he passed away?
No. Nothing.
How unfortunate. We are lost.
Must we resign ourselves to this disastrous turn of events?
No, General. Every part of me refuses to do so. Eugène de Vaucanson made me make a promise that I swore to keep. Now I have no other choice than to risk everything.
What are you thinking, Aegis?
I'm thinking of making my way to Versailles.
Eh bien, you should know that I also plan to go there.
You don't even think about it.
Ma foi.
What have we got to lose? Our lives? At this point, you must admit that they're not worth much.
I agree with the Marquis's resolution. We must take into account everything that Aegis has done to foil the King's plans. The time has come for us to put ourselves at her service.
Not so fast, mon ami. Let's not rush into anything. You'd have to be mad to want to be part of the battle to come. Those who agree to take part in this strike will need to keep a low profile until Aegis has cleared the way. As for you, madame, I do not know what new arrangements have been made since my last visit to the Queen, but I found the area around the North Wing to be particularly empty. Here is where you should launch the attack. If fortune is in my favor, I shall be waiting for you at the Petit Trianon with something to help you make your way through the gardens.
As for us, once the Automats have been defeated, we will enter the palace to seize the King and the Count.
Is that your plan, Monsieur le Marquis?
It is, Monsieur.
We are about to take the small step that separates audacity from madness.
Are you ready to take it, Madame?
Citoyen, I cannot escape my obligations. It is in my very nature to honor them. I kept the promise I made to the Queen to find Monsieur de Vaucanson. I am now bound by the oath I swore before my creator. If I go to Versailles, it is in the hope of rescuing Athenaïs. I think also of all that remains to be done in Paris. And what's more, you demand my help to make you masters of the King.
It is a heavy burden that we place on your shoulders. But once again, we must leave it up to you. Take your time, Aegis. A hasty decision could lead to disaster.
We will be ready for action when the time comes.
Pour la nation!
Et pour le royaume!
Aegis, a word, s'il vous plaît.
Aegis, just...